What's up, YouTube? It's Yardy Tell Andor that talks to react to another video. We got jokes that are darker than your future with Laugh Planet. And it's starting off with Anthony Jeselnik. So let's get into
it. It's my neighborhood. We're playing hide and go seek. And one of them ended up in an abandoned refrigerator. It's all anybody talked about for weeks. I said, who cares? How many kids you know get to die a winner?
If only Africa had more mosquito nets, then every year we could save millions of mosquitoes from dying needlessly of AIDS.
Watch your back, are you a doctor or something like that? What's your job? Which prison? Is that where Ghislaine Maxwell was? Yeah, I was asleep. Yeah, we heard that. We heard that before. Oh, I fell asleep. And then I just got a brand new house in Long Island for some reason. I fell asleep. What a shame. And if you see them, like, each other, do you don't stop it, or what do you do? You hear it, though. You hear motherfuckers screaming. Put your fucking AirPods on. Do not disturb.
Hear this shit. Hear this shit.
Don't you away. Long ago, on the road, I got what they're waiting for. Got that Lil Nas X pumping while that dude got that Lil Nas X pumping, bro.
I've had a few medical problems this year. I'm now so old that my pussy is haunted.
The fuck do you need a GoFundMe for a dead kid? The only time I've seen it in a story is where it says to help pay for funeral costs, which is another scam altogether. A funeral, you just fucking, it's dead, it doesn't care. Dead things don't give a fuck about all your goings on, and you're gonna get a headstone and a coffin for what? You're gonna buy a cemetery plot for a dead kid? You're gonna buy real estate for a dead thing while you're still renting? Does that make any sense at all? See, a little more energy this time, huh?
Real estate, really.
You have something that you loved that's now dead. That vessel is still sitting there. You donate it to science. It's what you do. You fucking spend money on some nonsense dead things don't care about you. No, my parents both died and we donated both of their bodies to science because you can't chuck it in a dumpster. It's illegal for some reason. You donate it to science, and what happens then is you actually help the world. You donate it to science, they show up, they pick up your dead thing, they ship it off free of charge to a medical university where some hungover 19-year-olds are gonna gut open your Aunt Betty and start flipping around her internal organs like it's a Benihana and chase each other around with your mom's pancreas. Quit it! Quit it! I'm gonna hurl! Still drunk! Get it down! Yo. But maybe one of those kids is actually paying attention, and somehow your donated dead thing will, he finds a cure for something, for some disease or malady that actually helps society from your donation rather than you just being some weird corpse hoarder. And then you did a good thing for the world. That kid's Asian, by the way. I know they say that there's no heartache worse than having to bury it's your own child. And I have to give that to you. I wouldn't know. I've never been in that position and never put myself at that kind of disadvantage by having one.
Yeah, I ain't having no kids.
But if that is true, that that's the worst heartache, that proves my point that there's a huge difference between a child and a fetus. because I never had to bury my own child. But did have to pony up for an abortion when it was my turn to grab the check. And heartache with an abortion? I could have watched live footage of that abortion on closed circuit TV while eating spaghetti and still gotten distracted and started checking my tweets. The only heartache you'll ever feel with an abortion is if you chug the champagne too quickly afterwards.
Gave him a whole sitting.
And if you started a GoFundMe page for an abortion, I would kick in a few dollars and retweet that to my Twitter followers, because that is an effort worth investing in for the planet.
Who do you think was smarter, Jesus or Buddha? I mean, just in terms of not letting themselves get crucified.
An obese monkey in Thailand named Godzilla has been sent to a special facility to lose weight. Official realized the monkey was overweight when a bunch of black guys kept hitting on it.
Pete Davidson's here. I'm appalled that people would come here and make jokes about the sacrifice Pete's heroic father made on 9/11.
Oh,
this is not the roast of Pete Davidson's father. That was in 2001.
Yo, what the fuck?
Oh, that was dope.
Wow. What the fuck? When men are we up
on the slabs? You know, terrorists are just people who like to murder other people. And what the fuck is the big problem? Seriously, I think that they become victimized in this country because those are their religious beliefs and they have a right to them to murder people. Because here's the thing, what do they do that's so bad? They kill people. Who the fuck, well, who are, so what? What's so great about people that they shouldn't be allowed to murder them? Like, I was really thinking about that. Like, so people die, yeah? Fucking, I don't know them, so I honestly don't care. And if somebody, well, what if somebody you knew died? Well, that would be sad, but then there's the other side to it, which is I'd get to act sad and people would be worried about me and really concerned about me. You know, like when you were in school, did you ever have when you were in school, when you were a kid, like fantasies about your parents dying so that you'd be really special in school, like when your parents got killed?
No.
You'd go to school and they'd make an announcement, Joey's parents died today, so everybody, and all the cute girls would come up and go, are you okay? And stuff like that, which would never happen. They'd just walk up and you go, I'm still not gonna fuck you, you faggot. That's what would have happened. And that would have even, I would have jerked off to that and had a better time than if I fucked them. Seriously, to me, jerking off later to a cute girl saying that to me after my parents died, like the brutalness of that, would have gotten me off better than fucking that stupid bitch. Her. I don't need her.
My mom was the worst.
Hey, so if you think about, so if you had sex when you was 15, you think about it when you're 30. Are you a pedophile now? I know if you have sex at 15, and then you think about that sex at 30, you'd be like, "Dang, I wish I could get that back." Are you a pedophile now? Question of the day.
I'd happen to break bad news to her children. I remember I came home from school one day, she said, Anthony, I don't know how to tell you this, but I've been having an affair, and you can't tell Dad. I said, well, why not? She said, because he just passed away.
But now there's so much outrage, and we hear about it, and it's taken seriously, you know? There's Oxbridge comedians writing for the posh papers, thinking of the rules of comedy, they're laying it down, laying down the law, right? And it's all stuff like, comedy should punch up. You should never punch down. You should never punch down. Sometimes you've got to punch down. Like, if you're beating up a disabled toddler. You know what I mean? If you punch up, you'll miss the little cunt and he'll win, you know? I like that joke because it highlights the difference between metaphorical punching down in jokes and actual punching down. But people nowadays want you to believe that words are actual violence, right? Now, you laughed at a joke about beating up a disabled toddler. No one got hurt. If I'd have actually dragged out a disabled toddler and started beating him up, you would laugh, right? That's why I dropped that bit.
But this is the end of the video. Like, comment, subscribe. They shouldn't have put that long section, that long chunk of video person right there. But that's the end of the video. Like, comment, subscribe, follow the link in the description. Y'all to tell them out, man.